André Pierre here, he's an artist that died a few years ago, began painting around about 1950, so quite early on. And here you see another voodoo spirit, Simbi, who's a god of fresh water in the forest, in nature. But again, very much in the kind of garb of a Haitian revolutionary. You can see the clothes he's wearing don't belong to 20th century, they belong to something like 1800, the time of the revolution. And he's very fine looking, his kind of long hair and his earring and all this amazing braiding and the epaulettes and his long decorative sword. You can see a little symbol at his feet, and this is called a veve. And veves are made at the beginning of voodoo ceremonies. They're made using something like corn flour, some kind of white grain like substance. And the voodoo priest will make a drawing of the symbol on the floor by pouring this flour. And each of these symbols is particular to the god they represent. And through them, gods are attracted down. They're almost like kind of codes to the supernatural realm by which one can kind of summon down a god. So here the god appears to have been summoned in a natural setting in a forest. Here are other members of the Gede family, the kind of gods of death, the dead. And here is Madame Brigitte, his consort. And the Gede Nibo, Baron Sambi's secretary, it says secretaire baron. And at their feet, again, are their various veves. So Baron Samdi's is recognizable from being a cross with a skull on it. Seems to have a bottle of rum by it. They're all wearing black, purple, and white. These are the Gede colors. And here you can see written in French, here are the spirits of the dead. You see this esprit de mort. And you can see all these graves around. So these would be kind of ancestors, and perhaps ancestors on their way to becoming the millions and millions of much lesser known spirits. And the subject of this one is a ceremony to Agwe and La Siren. We met La Siren earlier, the mermaid, and she's the consort of Agwe, who's another powerful god, but in this case, the god of the sea. He's very much, if Ogu is a general, then he's very much an admiral. And again, evoking the time of the revolution. Napoleon said, rid me of these gilded Africans and I'll have nothing else to wish for. And here you see a ceremony in action. You see a raft in the middle, and the raft is full of foodstuff and offerings, and it's going to be floated on the sea. So the animals would be sacrificed, the raft floated on the ocean, and when the raft sinks, it's believed that the voodoo gods have or Agwe has accepted the offering. In Dufaux, you get the sense, like his paintings of Jacques Mel, of a massive sky. And the voodoo gods are not, you don't know how big they are. In fact, they could be huge. They look like they're towering presences. They're also a little bit architectural, which kind of calls to mind these magical urban landscapes. So here you see a god called Papa Marionette de Laval, and he's presented quite abstractly. You see his arms are all geometric, and they're kind of bathed in fire, or bathed in blood, and emerging from the sacred drum. And he's covered in horns, and horns which are really kind of bull's horns, really. The bull is also a voodoo spirit, Bosu. Horns are points of energy in Haitian voodoo. So a voodoo cross will have little curlicues with points on the end, bull's horns, points of spiritual energy. Again, you see attributes of voodoo ceremonies, the bell, the sacred rattle. McCandle was a historical figure before the revolution. He was recognizable because he'd lost an arm in the sugarcane machinery. Sugar was the main industry of Haiti, of Saint-Domingue, and Saint-Domingue produced over half of Europe's sugar. It was the most profitable colony in the world under the French. Most voodoo loirs belong to two main nations, as they're called, nations of spirits. And one is called Rada,
And the Radha spirits can be tracked back to African sources. So the Gede, Ogu, and others belong to them. They tend to be more familiar, and they tend to be more benevolent. And the other big nation of spirits is called Petuo. And they're much harsher. They're tempestuous, they're angry. And these gods came into being in Saint-Domingue during slavery. So they're spirits of the New World, of the Americas. And they're revolutionary spirits and very associated with the revolution. Kafur, the spirit after which a title is named, is a spirit of the crossroads. A spirit has an equivalent in the other big nation of gods. So his equivalent is Legba in the Radha family, who's better known, a very important god in Africa. In Africa, he's a young man, he's very virile, but in Haitian voodoo, he's an old man, as if he's borne the pain and experience of Haitian history across the Atlantic world and through slavery. But here is his kind of younger sibling or cousin in the Petuo family. So Legba opens the gate for the other spirits. Kafu is the guardian of the crossroads. And if you're not careful, he can let diabolic spirits through.